I think each of you know that the main purpose for this year's survey, as it is every year, is to get input from residents in the community about how well you're providing services and what the priorities are. Each year we contact over 1,200 residents to ask them what they think about a wide variety of issues. And the reason we do that is that you look at today's public meeting, there aren't a lot of people here. In fact, we did a national survey a couple years ago, and we asked people whether or not they had attended a public meeting within the past year, and a whopping 4% of the people said yes. The number one reason they showed up is they wanted to get recognition for themselves or see somebody else get an award. Number two was they didn't like something you were doing. Number three, they wanted to change something that would benefit them. So as a result, you hear from special interests, which are an important group, but most of the people who are just going through their lives probably aren't going to have time to come to a meeting. So without a tool like this, you may not actually hear from the average resident. So it's one of many sources of information to use, but certainly an important one. As I indicated, this year's survey, we administered over 1,200 residents. The actual number was 1,429. So the data for each of the six districts is statistically valid and will provide breakdowns so you can actually see what your constituents think along with what the county perceptions are from everyone who lives in the community. The results aren't perfect. They have accuracy of about plus or minus 2.6% at the 95% level of confidence. And that just means if you did the survey 100 times, you'd see the same results within about 3%, 95 times out of 100. So it's a pretty good indicator of what people think. And this map just shows where people live. And the little red dots are the general location of their homes. And as you can see, we have good representation from all areas of the county in proportion to the way the county's population is distributed. So all in all, we felt real good about the composition of the sample this year, geographically and demographically. It's also very consistent to what we've had in previous years. So for those reasons, we feel that the changes and the results that we found this year are representative of the community. So with that said, here's some of the things that we found. First thing, not a real surprise because it hasn't changed. Overall satisfaction with Johnson County is very high. In fact, it's not just high, it's among the highest in the entire nation. You're clearly in the top 5% of all counties when it comes with regard to their satisfaction with their community and their local government. You can see the real intensity of that perception based on the percentage of residents who give a 5 rating or an excellent rating, with over 60% rating this community as an excellent place to live and raise children, and almost no one giving negative ratings. In addition, when we see how the trends have changed, we thought when we first started doing the survey, it couldn't get better. Well, there wasn't much room to get better, but you can see now as a place to live, 98% of residents think this is a good or excellent place to live, which is up 2%. It doesn't seem like a lot, but there wasn't much to go up. You're at 96% as a place to raise children and 89% as a place to work. So this is definitely a community that is probably going to continue to attract people from other areas, attract businesses from other areas, which is a very healthy indicator. In addition, the overall perceptions of the county, particularly those of the county government, are very, very strong. In fact, I want to highlight just a couple of things on this list. If you come to the fourth bar down, it's the overall quality of county services, and you can see 84% give positive ratings. Another 14% think things are okay. Only 2% gave negative ratings. So for every person out there that you hear from that thinks the county doesn't do a good job providing services, there's 41 people out there that would disagree with that. You're probably not going to hear from most of them, which is one of the reasons it's good to have the survey information. In addition, when it comes to value for taxes, if you look for the second from the bottom, you'll see 64% give positive ratings compared to just 9% negative. So again, a 7-to-1 ratio. So this county is definitely doing a lot of things right. In addition, we found that the county's ratings, if you just look at some of the trends, remain high, and the county's definitely moving in the right direction. You'll notice for all the county services that were assessed, the majority generally stayed the same or got better. I've highlighted those that had significant changes from last year, either with an arrow moving up as a significant increase or an arrow moving down as a significant decrease. You'll notice that the areas that went down a little bit were Johnson County Emergency Management, Stormwater, and County Human Services, but you'll see there were significant improvements in the library, the K-State Research and Extension and Research, the Johnson County Museums, the Sheriff's Office, Johnson County Health and Environment, Public Works, it's a long list to read, Johnson County Development Supports, Johnson County Planning Inspections, and the Department of Corrections all showed significant improvement over last year. So definitely things are looking very good. In addition, when we look at how things have changed long-term, we have a composite index that takes all of the items that we assess for the county and kind of gives you a single number, kind of like a consumer price index, where 100 reflects the first year we did the survey, and the current number is at 103. That means compared to when we started, you've gone up 3 points. And we had a little blip, which was a strange year back when we had the recession back in 2009. But for the most part, we've seen pretty steady improvement since then. It's actually up 6 points if you go back to 2011. During that same period, you'll see the Kansas City Metro gone up a little bit, and the national average for large communities has actually gone down. So you've kind of gone against the trend nationally for large communities. So you're definitely doing something right. In addition, when we see how you stack up to other communities, this is really a cause celebration, but also the need to continue moving forward, because sometimes if you get all happy where you're at, you don't keep getting better or sustaining the levels you're at. And just look at what how you rate compared to other large communities, which is in yellow, and the national average, which is in red. And this is based on a national survey we do about every 18 months. When it comes to this place to live, you're 44 points above the average for other large communities. That's not just a significant difference, that's a phenomenal difference. When it comes to a place to raise children, you're 46 points. When it comes as a place to work, you're more than double what the other large community is at 89 to 44. And as a place to retire, which a lot of folks don't think, typically Kansas is where I'd love to go retire. I go to Florida, Arizona, you're still outperforming other large communities by 25%. In addition, when it comes to satisfaction with perceptions and image of the county, I want to highlight just a couple of these because they're pretty much all in the double digits. But look at the overall quality of services provided. You're at 84%, as I mentioned before. National average for large communities is 45%, nearly double. And when it comes to the value for taxes, which if you work your way down to the second to the bottom, you're at 64% compared to 31%, which is more than double the national average for large communities. So you're definitely doing lots of things right. But with that said, there's definitely opportunities to continue moving things forward. And so one of the things that we did in the analysis here is not only do we ask people how satisfied they are with services, we also ask them, well, how important are those services? And the rationale is if everybody was dissatisfied with something, it might not, and nobody cared about it, they're probably not going to notice or actually might not want you to spend more money on that service. So what we're trying to look at is what do people really care about and what is your performance, and look at those two variables together to help identify ways to do better when it comes to overall satisfaction. You can see the top rated services overall, the top highest priorities are the sheriff's office, emergency medical, county parks, libraries. A lot of that has to do with usage. Some of the ones that are used more tend to be more important to more people. So when we do the analysis, we actually then also look at the satisfaction rating that folks gave. And the three items that rose to the top of the list as being the top opportunities for improvement, sheriff's office, human services, and mental health, followed by district courts and public works. But those are the things, if you focus on those over the next year or two, you'll probably see the best opportunity to improve overall satisfaction with county services. Just a couple other findings as we asked people whether or not it was important to provide safety net services to low-income families, and you can see the vast majority of people thought that was important. In fact, if you add it all up, you have almost 90% of the people at least thinking it's somewhat important. When we also asked them, what if state and federal funding for certain services were reduced, how would you support the use of additional county funds essentially to make up for some of those reductions? And you'll see the ones that people supported the most were mental health services, public health services, and aging programs. And you see there was general support across the board for everything. Even though public transportation is at the lowest end of the scale, you still had 72% of the people that would support additional funding for that if state and federal funding were reduced. So just to summarize things, a lot to be very happy with in this year's report. You are definitely one of the top performing communities in the country, particularly among counties. The desirability of this community is really almost second to none. Statistically, you're one of the top performing places in almost every area that we assessed. But in order to stay there, things like human services, things like health services, making sure people continue to feel safe are going to be very important in the years ahead. So I don't know if anyone has any questions, but that's just a highlight of the things that we found this year.